believe it or not, it's not relevant. The idea is that I have done a base with phase 2 equipment with only one single load, which was when I killed the Roborex, because I moved my troops 4 bases away and it actually blew up 5 bases away. Other than that, absolutely not a single load. This is the second time, and last time I did a P4 with a P3, that was either 1 or 2 loads, but shit like that in both cases, so nothing gameplay related. So it is doable. It is really, really, really doable. And next time I will not be such an idiot and I will actually record it. But no matter, I am actually recording everything from now on. Save game. Should I do? Which one I'm gonna do, which is actually the reason why I'm doing Andron bases, which grants me armor. Let's see. Okay. Save game. Yes, by the way, the Hyperion is actually working. This is the gear I went in with, and I actually ran out of ammo. If you can believe something. I ran out of ammo and was left with one medkit. So phase 3 with phase 2 weapons. Androns. It can be done. It wasn't even that difficult. As I've said, it's just knowing who you deal with. Not the base layout, no. Not the base layout, but the enemies. And yes, I do find the proposed conditions of for voluntary airmen very, very acceptable and very, very okay. If you really want to get the spirit of the game. But I like it. It's a good idea. I like it. Oh yes, and I encountered the blue variety of Roborex. It blows up quite a big bang. As you may have seen, I really like the plasma flamethrower. It's really good. just for the kicks. Fuck. Okay.
It's a lot more rewarding going in order.